After years of being stuck in limbo, Disney has finally gone ahead and allowed Dave Filoni to complete his vision for the Clone Wars with Season 7. All that remains now is to ask ourselves, the fans, on whether the season was truly worth that long wait. Season 7 is a pretty unique season, as not only does it have the least amount of episodes in it, but also the least amount of story arcs seen out of any other season, giving us a total of 3 out of the 12 story arcs that were originally planned to be made before Disney cancelled the series. What we got in the end was the Bad Batch arc, the Martez sister arc, and of course the Siege of Mandalore arc. Looking back at these, it's not too surprising to see that some fans would have hoped Lucasfilm could have done a better job picking which arcs would be included in Season 7 over others. The Bad Batch arc is the first that we get in Season 7, and as I said in my separate episode reviews for that entire arc, I really got a kick out of it. It focused mainly on the clones, the entire war aspect of the Clone Wars, we got to see elite clones do what they do best, and of course Anakin tagged along as well, so really it was, at least for me, a great choice to come back into this beloved series. Now, would I have chosen a different arc over this one had I had a choice? Possibly. But to be honest, it's hard to choose anything different over the Bad Batch arc, as most of the other original planned unfinished arcs didn't focus nearly as much on the clones as this one. And yeah, while it would be great to see another Anakin and Kenobi-centric story, like the Crystal Crisis on Utapau or maybe the Bounty Hunter arc, ultimately it's undeniable that the clones are one of the best things in this whole series, so they should get their own arc. So I feel the Bad Batch here was in the end a great choice. Next, we got the Martez sister arc, which ended up being the weakest one for almost everyone who watched the series. Now, I already knew not to expect too much from this arc just based on the trailer alone. However, since I went into it with low expectations already, plus I binged the entire arc all in one sitting, I gotta say, I didn't hate it, I know. I ended up enjoying it for what it was, a small, almost meaningless side mission, which shouldn't be anything novel for us considering this series is packed with small little side mission arcs already. The Martez sisters were a bit annoying at first, but they ended up growing on me. It was also great to visit Obadiah and see the Pikes again, along with Ahsoka just genuinely being the best thing about this arc overall. And that's kind of the whole reason this arc was chosen, as Filoni wanted to have one arc that focused on Rex, and another on Ahsoka before bringing them together for the last and final one. And yeah, that totally makes sense, at least on paper. However, in my honest opinion, I'd rather they had instead done either the Son of Dathomir or the Return to the Jedi Temple arc. For Son of Dathomir, it's a no-brainer because it would show us how Maul escaped from Palpatine and regained power on Mandalore. However, true, if we did get that instead, then we wouldn't have gotten a whole arc focused on Ahsoka, but truth be told, I would be fine with that, mainly on account Ahsoka didn't really do anything too major in the Martez sister arc. So by skipping that for the Son of Dathomir arc, we wouldn't have really missed out on much, if anything. But if we really did have to have an Ahsoka arc before the Siege of Mandalore, then yeah, I would have loved to see the Return of the Jedi Temple arc. Not only is that an Ahsoka-focused arc, but it also includes both Anakin and Obi-Wan too. Plus, we would have got to see the Sith Temple underneath the Jedi Temple on Coruscant, as well as Ahsoka encountering Darth Sidious too. Now, that would have been a lot of fun to see. Last but not least is the Siege of Mandalore arc, and whoa, there just aren't enough words to describe of how beautiful, emotional, and epic this was. Like the Martez sister arc, I waited to binge watch this all in one sitting, and boy, am I glad I did. Not only is the production value here immense, but I'd wager this is one of the best stories this series has to offer. Now, having said that, I don't think it was absolutely perfect, as I did find Ahsoka and the Maul duel to be a little underwhelming, as well the final episode feeling a tad bit too rushed in some parts. But overall, this arc was amazing and set the bar extremely high for future Star Wars animation projects as a whole. The action, music, the feels in this arc, especially the Order 66 part, was just incredibly well done. Like all of us, I knew the Siege of Mandalore arc was going to be good and the highlight of Season 7, but damn, never did I imagine it be this good. And don't lie, neither you did too. This story arc alone feels like its own separate animated movie. And what can I say, it truly did bring justice to the end of the Clone Wars that George has started. All in all, Season 7 was fantastic. Still too short in my opinion, but at least there was something for everyone to enjoy here. Love clones and the whole war aspect of the series, the Bad Batch has you covered. Want to see an all-female centric story? You've got the Martez sister arc. Want to see a true masterpiece featuring Death Watch, Maul, Ahsoka, Rex, and Order 66? The Siege of Mandalore has your number there. But what did you all think about Season 7? Did it meet all your expectations and more? Was it worth the wait? And did Lucasfilm pick the right story arcs for the last and final season? Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments down below. And if you haven't already, remember to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next one.